described Rishi Yadna, Manushi Yadna, Pitri Yadna, Deva Yadna, Bhuta Yadna. Rishi Yadna is Atmadarshana. Listening to Atmadarshana, participating in Yadna Karya, and teaching others. So these are the parts of Rishi Yadna. Manushi Yadna is service to human beings. Pitri Yadna is service to elders. Deva Yadna is puja, whatever puja you do, and also any activity you do for taking care of the environment, because devatas are responsible for the environment. Out of that, Rishi Yadna is the highest. It's called Jnana Yadna. Again and again, listen to the teachings of Rishis, understand, contemplate, then imbibe in your life, and if possible, give it to others. That's called Rishi Yadna. This is what we are doing, is called Rishi Yadna. So there's a difference between Yadna and Dana, you have to understand. So Dana is giving. Okay? Somebody is in trouble, you give Dana. Don't ask back. Whereas Yadna means you do something so that it grows. For example, some farmer gets 1 quintal of rice. So that one kg of rice, he keeps it for next crop. Like that, Dana is something you do for growing that activity. Okay, not for selfish reason, but for this society. For example, you learn something and you teach somebody else. Then what happens in the process? It grows. So that's called Rishi Yadna. So all Yadna, if you do it as an offering to Vishnu, the Lord, that will be purified. If you do it as a social service, it gives you good punya.
But it's karma.
It's karma. If you do it as an offering to Vishnu for purification of yourself, it becomes Sukrati. So what is Dharma is simple. What is good for me, I will do it to others. What is not good for me, I will not do to others. If
fifth yajna, no? Bhuta yajna.
Yeah, Bhuta yajna means taking care of animals. Not harming the animals. Okay? Reducing the torture for animals. So, reducing whatever activity you do to reduce the suffering of animals. So, let us say what the now each of us have to focus in life. Okay, we are actually so much distracted in life right now without Atmadarshana. Okay, let us say you have to do something in life, service, whatever is that. You need to focus. You cannot do 10-100 things. Rishi Yadna, Deva Yadna, Pitra Yadna, Manushi. You should focus on one. You cannot do more than multiple things. Right? So how many years your life?
Huh?
No. How many years you will live for? How many more years you will live? Eshtu varsha badukirthira?
Uncertain.
Don't know. So that's why you have to live for every day in a right way. So there's nothing we should postpone. For all you know, tomorrow morning we may not be there. The life, there's no guarantee or warranty. So every day spend some time on Atmadarshana, some time in Dharma. You don't know when life disappears. Okay, life is a gift. Every day you have to focus on that. Don't postpone for something for tomorrow. Little bit every day. Right? Assume that you live for next 20 years. Assume that. Nobody can give a guarantee, right? No doctor can give a guarantee. So if next 20 years you have to live, okay? At least 8 hours per day you are spent. Daily 1/3 of that will go into sleep. Okay, out of 20 years, how many years gone?
8 years. Almost 8 years. 7 years.
Yeah, okay, let's say 12 years are left. out of that every day you need about 4, 5 or 6 hours for your day-to-day activities. Okay, how many days are gone now?
4 years.
Huh?
4 years.
4 years are gone. So how many years are left? 8 years are left. Right? So 8 years in a period of 20 years is whatever you can do for some sadhana, if you do it properly. It's actually much lesser than that. And every day you have to focus, it's not tomorrow. Every day little bit you have to do, because life is uncertain, you can't get guarantee, okay? And once you slip into adnana, it goes into millions of lifetimes, it's not one lifetime. Jnana is very rare, okay? So in adnana we can just spend millions of lifetimes without knowing where we are going. So jnana you have to imbibe in your life, spend, give some time for atmadnana every day. So spend time atmano mokshartam for your own liberation, atmadnana, whatever you possibly do. And jagadhita is dharma, so for sharing that joy and peace with others, whatever is possible, do a little bit every day. This is what is actually purpose of life. Karma can be only broken with jnana. No other possibility is there. Without jnana, no karma. Karma cannot be, cannot escape from karma. This I have told, no? That feeling, emotions, thinking I have already told, right? You people? Huh?
Yes.
What?
Last time
Sense, okay. That's anatha chakra. Okay. So today let us look into what is samadhi. So jnana, how do you get jnana? Okay. It is totally different from karma. Right? This is not a meditation class. So if you think that I will come here and learn a meditation technique and practice for 1 million years, no. So there are all different types of classes. There are yoga classes where you learn some meditation, some breathing practice, and practice every day religiously. Atmadhyana is not a practice actually. Atmadhyana is understanding. If your understanding gets clear, a lot of freedom happens. If your understanding is not clear, even if you do million times of meditation, nothing will happen. So jnana is very different. In bhakti class you will say chant God's name 1 million times. In yoga class they will say breathing practice 1 million times. In yoga class you say dhyana here for some every day. In jnana class it's not about doing. It's the clarity. Okay. Either you get a clarity or you don't get a clarity. ಯಾ ಫೋನ್ ಕೇಳುವೆ
ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಸ್ವಪ್ನ ಸತ್ಯ ಹಚ್ಚ
ಅಯ್ಯೋ ರಾಮ ರಾಮ್ ಅಂತ ಬಿತ್ತರೆ ಸೊಡ್ದಾನ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ ಅನ್ನಿ ಸಂತೆ ಪೆಂಡ್ ಇರ್ಗಲ್ಲ ನಾವ ವಾಟ್ ಏನು ನಿಮಿಷ ಅಲ್ಲಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇನ್ ಗೇಟಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಏಕ್ನಿಮಿಷ ಮೇನ್ ಗೇಟಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಡ್ತಾರಂತೆ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂತ ದೋನ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಸರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಓ